All right, guys, welcome back to the channel. We are in my brand new 2022 Lund 1875 Crossover XS. It's a beautiful boat. We've only got a couple of hours on it, still doing the break-in. And we're gonna do our first mod for the boat. And as you can see, we've got our standard mercury gauges here. It's a really nice cluster. They do give you a pretty big platform here, and I have a balls-out mount. But this maybe kind of dwarfs a little bit. You would think maybe, oh, this platform's not big enough. Well, no, this is a Helix 15, and it's awesome, but it's just massive. So if you ever want to know if a Helix 15 or maybe a little smaller Helix 12 will fit in here, yes, it'll fit in here, but it takes up a lot of real estate. It covers up a lot of the window, and we're going to try to address that today, and I'm still kind of planning how we're going to do this, but Lund, if you were to order this boat, and I didn't order this, I got this off a showroom floor when the last couple of boats were left here in January of 2020. You can order with these analog gauges that we have here, which most boats come with, or you can get the mercury vessel view gauges, or really, it's really a screen, and that kind of flush mounts in here, and there's an upcharge for that. Well, I found the part number, and I'll put it down below because I don't remember it exactly, but I'll put it there. You can buy this. This is a genuine Lund part from a Lund dealer, and that's what I did. It was $220, something like that, which is expensive for a piece of plastic, but that's what it was. And what we're going to try to do is remove this bezel. There's just some screws here and over there and a couple in the back. Take the gauges out, or I may end up burying the gauges in here. Haven't figured it out yet. We'll see how it goes. But in any case, remove this entire section here and replace it with this guy. And I'm going to put a piece of aluminum I've already got. I'm still kind of figuring out exactly how I'm going to mount that, but a pretty thick piece of aluminum. I got a quarter inch, 6 by 12 plate that we'll have to shave off a little bit. Mount that plate to this, and then mount the gimbal mount that's behind this helix to that plate, and essentially take this entire helix unit and put it here and drop it down, so maybe put on a little bit of an angle and enough where it's comfortable. I can see out of the windshield comfortably, not interfere with handling the boat or the controls, anything like that. And repurpose this balls-on mount here to maybe my vessel view mobile or maybe another graph. We'll see what fits, but that's the general plan. That's what we're going to try to do today. All right, so we're at the workbench, and what I have here is a piece of aluminum plate. This is 6 by 12 by 1/4 inch. It's pretty thick. It's either going to be too thick or it's going to be just right. We'll see how that works. And the plan is to take this and mount it to this area right here. This is a little bit bigger than the area that's provided here in the bezel. What I'll probably have to do at the minimum is maybe round off these sharp corners here with the grinding wheel. This has a pretty unique contour to it. I'm not going to try to match this. This is probably just a little too much work. And quite honestly, once I get the helix, it's going to be bigger than all this anyway. But I want to take off some of these sharp corners here. So we'll do that. We'll mount it. We'll see what it looks like. This plate you can get at Amazon. I think I paid about $20 for it. I'll leave that link below in the description.
Tight, they can get it out. If it's tight, you don't want to get out.
Dumbass, you can't hit the button twice.
Getting them gauges out. Tedious.
All right, so here's what the bowels of the helm looks like. If you ever wanted to see what lies beneath, it's all of this. So removing gauges is, well, removing gauges. There is a wire harness here I was able to disconnect here from here that got some of it freed up, but there's just wires everywhere, so you're just gonna have to disconnect them. You may have a more efficient way of doing it, but that's what I had to do. I just kind of grouped them to what gauge goes with what, so if I ever have to reinstall something, I will know what that is. I intended to maybe reconnect them and bury them down here, and I'll do that if I end up setting off some kind of code or alarm or something like that for not having a gauge hooked up. We will see. This particular engine is designed to have vessel view mobile, so I should be able to disconnect them without an issue, but we will find out. All right, we're just doing a bit of a test fit here. This is on here loose, but the plate's on here, it's secure, it looks pretty good, almost looks like it belongs there. We're figuring out how long we need this connection piece for the helix to be. I'm gonna repurpose this balls up mount where the helix was, and I've got my RAM mount for my phone attached to it, so even though it sticks up a little bit here, once the phone's on, it'll sit like that, it'll look really nice, and I'll have my vessel view mobile on my phone there. Can't show you right now because I'm using my phone to record, but that's where that'll go, and then we'll finalize that position as well. What I think I'm noticing is, although these dimples for the screws that came out of the old piece here, you can see I have a few here and I have a few in the back. They look like they're the same, in the same position, but they're actually a little bit different. These front ones, no big deal. I'll just recenter this. I'll re-drill the front ones. The problem we're going to have is these back ones. I'm not sure if the camera's going to pick it up through the windshield, but it's way back here where my first finger's at, and the same with the other side here. I may not be able to get something back here to drill it in. We'll see how that goes. I'm certainly not going to mess with taking the windshield off. You can forget that. So I may have to kind of front load this with a few extra screws, so I'll definitely do these here, but I may, put a few more in here and here. Looks like there's some supporting material underneath here, as well as kind of lower down here, there's some supporting material I can drill into. So even if I do get part of the back done, I may still put a few more here in the front. This is going to hold a lot more weight than I did before. I don't want it to go anywhere. So one of the keys of being successful at drilling holes through metal like this is having a good sharp, newer bit, and having your drill running on a lower speed with some good pressure. If you're running at a high speed and you get that whining sound, you're not doing it right. Low speed, put some pressure on it, your hand's gonna hurt a little bit. You kind of want these longer shavings coming out. You'll get the little ones too, but as long as you're getting these little ones, you're cutting through it pretty good. These are all tight, and then here's what the back looks like. Just want to keep in mind, keep these guys up when you go to mount your helix. So an observation that I made is on the old unit, I just kind of put the gauges back in there so they'd be out of the way. But this tray that's here is shorter than this tray. And you think that's no big deal until you come over here and you realize it doesn't sit on this exactly right. It sits in the back very well, but the front, it's got a little bit of a lip that, or a gap I'm trying to overcome. And it looks like these little corners here, I'll have to take a cutting wheel and trim a little bit of this out to overcome the larger tray. Yay me. So I was just able to use my drumming tool with the cutting wheel on it and able to kind of notch these out. I'll probably take a little file or sandpaper and kind of clean it up a little bit. Careful work with this is fiberglass, so you know, wear gloves and safety gear and stuff like that for your eyes. But let me reach over here and grab the new mount. Hang on one sec. Once you put the new mount in, it now sits as it should because there's no room for this tray. Come to the side here. I mean, it's that's a pretty good. That's how it should look. When I had this before, there was a gap. You know, kind of like that. I mean, it was terrible. Like, what's going on? Why isn't that seating well? You had to make those couple little cutouts. So something to keep in mind when you're doing this. I had some, scrap pieces of metal here that I formed into some tabs and fixed them to the back here. I got to do a little more tweaking on it, but I'm going to test fit it first and see if I can shove these tabs under the rest of the fiberglass helm. And see if that'll keep the back in place as I screw in the front. So here's the, what I think is going to be the finished view. We've got the helix all set up here. This is the straight up and down kind of a view, and I'll go over a few different positions here in a moment. But I've got a really, really great view up over this thing. You know, leaning over a little bit, I can see just about everything, and of course sitting back, I'm just missing a little bit of the gunwale here, no big deal. So much improved visibility here. Of course, I have all the visibility here. I've got a little bit of an eye issue on the right side, so you know, having this extra visibility here is really, really important. I was about to put the phone. That's also important because without the gauges here, I don't have a fuel gauge or a tachometer. Of course, I have speed here and stuff, but I do have Vessel View Mobile. For Mercury, so I'll have that in the phone. I'll have that right there, so I'll get my a redundant speed, but I'll also have tachometer, fuel, and different things. I'll show a quick little snippet of that. So I also have my cup holder back, so we've got good Wisconsin beer, so that's super awesome. And just, I think, you know, overall a much, you know, much improved, cleaner look. Now, this is, again, straight up and down. If I go down a position, actually even two, you know, of course, I got plenty of room here. You know, I basically can see completely out of the dash or through the windshield, rather. You know, I'm probably never going to run it like this, but if I need it a pinch, I can bring it down. The straight up and down view, I lose a little bit of visibility here, but not too bad. And, of course, if I start to go up, I do start to lose a little bit of hand space here. Of course, I'm pretty good at this position. And again, I have most of the view of the screen here, as well as a pretty good visibility. And let's say I get to where I'm going and I'm just fishing. You know, I don't need to see out of the front of the boat, you know, extremely well or anything like that. I'm trolling or something like that. I pretty much have, except for a little bit right here, you know, visibility of the entire screen. And then, you know, again, I can do my trolling and, you know, still have decent visibility even all the way up. So, you know, this is what it looks like. A couple of lessons learned here. One, don't get a Helix 15 unless you have space for it. I mean, you saw at the beginning of the video, it physically fits here, but it takes up a lot of real estate. Going kind of behind it here, I did end up raising this a little bit from its original position. You can see the couple holes down there. No big deal. It just makes this thing adjustable. So this sits a little bit higher than I originally had it. A few extra screws here. The original spot there, but I put one here. I put one here. I might just kind of tap these black. In an earlier segment of the video, I had little tabs out of the back. that didn't hold it. So I've got a couple of inside corners. These are galvanized. I just got painted black, and I may have to touch them up a little bit. Again, I haven't cleaned up. That's just dust from drilling through the fiberglass here. But just painted those black. And this is really the only extra hole, you know, one on this side and one on the other side. The only extra holes I have drilled in this thing that would be visible if I ever like undid this. All these other holes and stuff, they'll get buried by, you know, if I put the other, you know, bezel back in, they'll cover all that up. So that's it with those extra brackets in the back. Sorry, I got it loose, but it holds it really, really well. It's not going to go anywhere. And, yeah, I think I'm pretty happy with it. I'm going to go the season with it, see how it does. And, you know, I'll keep you guys updated if we have to do any improvements or any other modifications to it. So if you like this kind of stuff, think about leaving a like and a subscribe, and we'll see you next time.